Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Naoki from Japan. I'm very, very happy to be here as a startup. You need to use the device. First of all, let me start talking about my story. I went to college in the United States, and after graduation, I came back to Japan and worked for a big telecommunication company. And there, I was an engineer, and many of my colleagues asked for translations for the manuals, emails, and so on. And I didn't have that much time to do the translation for them, so I started looking for a translation service. At that time, I found two options. One is machine translation, which is free but very bad quality, like Google Translate. And the other one is translation agencies. They cost pretty much higher than than you expect. And the quality is quite good, but I couldn't find something that I wanted to have, like affordable, good quality translation. So I made this service. This is the service I created named Cognac. This is a crowdsourcing translation service. This is a human-powered translation. The strength of this service is the best part is the price. The price is very, very low. You can order translation as low as 10 times cheaper than the translation agencies. And the quality, we implemented evaluation system between translators, so the quality is kept by the translators. And the third one is the speed. Speed is very, very fast. You can get translations as fast as like 5 minutes. So these are the clients we have. People are using our service for their e-commerce businesses, social gaming, development, and so on. About the translator side, anybody can be a translator on our website. We have over 10,000 translators on our platform around the globe. We implemented the stepping up hierarchy system on our community system. First of all, you start from starter, and after getting good evaluations from other translators, you become standard translators. And after becoming a standard translator, you have to verify your identifications to accept business translations. After doing this business for a while, many companies ask us for the translations for their documents, very hard documents. And I answered it, why not? So we created a business version of Cognac. With that service, you can order translations to the specific, very good professional translators, and you can upload any kind of files, like office files, YAML file, development files. And you can use APIs with the service. This is the actual website. The process is very, very simple. You just upload files or upload text. And after that, selecting languages. And then it shows the points you need to pay. 1 point is 1 cent, 1 United States cents. And after paying that money, your request goes on to the translator's side. And after a while, you get a translation results after all. You can just download the text or files the translator has translated. And you can, if you like that translator, you can add the translator to your favorite, and you can ask that person again next time. We have increasing number of requests. Last year, we had only about 5,000 requests, and now we have about 35,000 requests per month. This is our team. We have various kind of people in our team. On the top three is our founders. Me, I'm doing the business side, on the center, we have a designer. He went to school in the United States as well. And the last one is our CDO. He's doing the programming. And we have a team member from various countries like United States. We have actual office in the United States right now. And we are hiring many people right now. We only had only three people at the end of last year, and we have now 20 members. And we are hiring more sales and marketing members and also engineers. So if you like to be a member, just, you know, email me. And lastly, I'm going to give you a question. For how long do you think we took to translate 200,000 letters of Japanese to Korean translations? Any guesses? Translation agencies I asked translation agencies, and they answered me it'll take like 1.5 months, and we did this translation in 9 hours. This is the power of crowdsourcing, and this is the power of Cognac. Thank you.
Thank you, Naoki. 아리가또.
Thank you.
어떻게 보셨습니까?
다른 분들이 이 질문을 하실 것 같아서 제가 먼저 질문을 하면요. 크라우드 소싱이 참 좋은데.
Can you hold on?
아, 예. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm okay?
I'm okay. Yeah.
크라우드 소싱이 참 좋지만 이 경우에는 번역이라는 게 굉장히 어떻게 보면 중요한 작업일 수 있는데 그 번역의 질을 어떻게 그 확신할 수가 있는지 어떻게 번역의 질을 담보할 수가 있는지 okay. 상당히 궁금합니다.
We have two points. One is we implemented evaluation system. Translators evaluate other translators' results, and if they turn in very bad translation results, they are going to be banned from the service. So that's one point. And after getting a good evaluations, their ratings goes up and become good translators and professional translators, and they can get more higher rewards from the requesters. And one point, we verify translators by we let translators upload their identifications like driver's license and other staffs, and we also do the agreements and non-disclosure agreement with the translators.
지금 알고리즘대로 돌아간다면 초기에 몇 명의 그 고객들은 질라진 번역을 받을 수밖에 없잖아요. 이 검증을 받기 위해서. 그 문제는 어떻게 해결하실 생각이신가요?
That is the point. we've been doing this business for a while. Actually, we do this business for 5 years now. And first 3 years, we didn't do a good job for the translators. It was pretty bad. But after getting good evaluations and bad evaluations from translators, the quality is getting higher and higher. And now we finally can provide translations to the business side.
제가 그 서비스를 쭉 봤는데요. 거기에 보면 일본어 영어보다는 좀 저희가 익숙하지 않은 언어들을 서비스 위주로 되어 있더라고요. 그래서 상당히 그 영어보다는 요구가 많이 있겠다라는 생각은 들었습니다. 그래서 궁금한데 어떤 지금 현재 그 요구 중에서 그 리퀘스트 중에서 어느 나라와 어느 나라 사이에 번역이 제일 많이 이루어져 있는가 하나 궁금하고요. 그 다음에 또 하나는 그 우리 번역 서비스에 저희가 좀 좋게 생각하는 건 뭐냐면 번역 서비스가 활성화되면 사실 사람이 개입할 여지가 없거든요. 스튜던트라고 하는 사람과 튜터라고 하는 사람, 아까 그렇게 돼 있고 또 이쪽에는 뭐 번역가와 번역을 리퀘스트한 사람하고 사이에서만 일어나는 일이고 거기에 나오는 수수료의 일부를 저희가 이 회사가 가질 수 있다는 매력 때문에 어떤 쉽게 말하면 장터죠. 그래서 그 사업의 스케일러빌리티가 있을 수 있다라고 하는 장점인데 반면에 이게 어떻게 보면은 진입장벽이 또한 낮기 때문에 아무나 들어와서도 쉽게 그 이런 비슷한 서비스를 구현할 수 있다는 게 약점일 것 같습니다. 그래서 우리가 대체 생각하기에 그 우리 꼬냑의 그 전략은, 그러니까 그 경쟁을 이길 수 있는, 그리고 진입장벽을 만들기 위한 전략은 무엇인지 궁금합니다.
Okay, thank you. First question. We have the biggest language pair we have is Japanese English, Japanese Korean, Japanese Chinese, and Indonesian to English is the biggest clients we have. And second question is the strategy. The barrier to enter this market is very low. That is correct. And the best strategy we have is the speed to gather more and more translators. We need a bunch of translators. Like, we currently have 10,000 translators, and at the end of this year, we are targeting to get 100,000 translators. And if we have that many translators, we can give the requesters with a very, very fast speed translations. So that is the biggest strategy. And for me, it's very important to have a good team members to create a good startup. So that is our strength, I think.
Just a quick question okay. about the content. You know, unlike one of the previous ones where it's very short form, mm-hmm. these are long form documents. Mm-hmm. So often the content will be very sensitive
okay.
and maybe very technical or specific. How do you keep your translators accountable for the work they do? You mentioned an NDA, but mm-hmm. do they anonymously do the translation or do they put their name on it and say, I did this translation so that there's some kind of accountability?
Yes, we show the translator's name on the translation results. And if the translator has to do the good translation after several, you know, translations, the translator get a good ratings and they don't want to lose that ratings, you know, after getting, you know, so much effort to the translations. So that is one thing, and that's about it. That can keep the secret from outside.
이용 지금까지 이용한 고객들에 대해서 좀 얘기를 해주셨으면 좋겠는데요. 보통 그 주 고객 군이 어떤 층인지 그리고 평균 고객이 얼마 정도를 그 지불하면서 쓰고 있었는지 한 달에 좀 얘기를 해주시죠.
We have consumer side and also the business side. Consumer side, average payments per user is about $100 per month. And the business side, we have many clients like TripAdvisor, Japanese big social gaming companies, and they pay a lot, like about $10,000 per month.
예, 그 만불이라는 숫자가 나오니까 갑자기 조용해졌네요.